and temperatures are still pretty sweltering here in North Florida. But the good news, the radar is clear. Still hydration will...
be the end of me. No, no. Probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play. All these catching penalties. Look, I don't like your energy. I don't like the fake handshakes.
The calendar may say autumn, but temperatures are still pretty sweltering here in North Florida. But the good news, the radar is clear. Still, hydration will be key today at TIAA Bank Field in Jacksonville. Today, it's week three, and we've got a good one in store between the Tennessee Titans and the Jacksonville Jaguars. It's the first weekend of autumn, and the NFL is in full swing as off we go on EA Sports. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
Here we go.
Now ETN to start the drive. And this will be a gain of five as he gets it to the 30. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady gain.
On second down, ETN once more. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down.
I think sometimes when you're trying to get after the quarterback, maybe it's better to be lucky than great. Because I think on that one, he's just trying to get upfield and rush the passer. Instead, the tackle for the loss landed right in his lap.
On third down, Burrow. He'll get this out to the flat for ETN. And he will have a Jaguars first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Here we go.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. The Jaguars are 1-1 through two games thus far. It's not a start that's going to set the world on fire, but they've been pretty solid nonetheless.
And the first thing that crosses my mind, it certainly beats the alternative of starting 0-2. I do think that this is a team that's going to take a little time to find its footing. Hard to navigate the always tough NFL.
From the 40 now on second down, Burrow, he'll get this off to ETN. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And now that sets up third and two.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back and it can turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. On fourth down, Matt Araiza sent on to punt. And look here, it's an opening drive fake. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. It's picked up by the Titans. And they'll take over inside the 45 at the 44-yard line. A little trickeration there, but it doesn't fool them. And this defense delivers a turnover on downs on the very first drive of the afternoon. They go play action here on first down. And he fires one that's intercepted.
Picked up by Tyree Gillespie.
And the Jaguars are going to take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the opening drive. That, Charles, the first interception he's thrown here in year number two.
And I know it's just the first one, but didn't it feel like what we saw from him last year, where he was plagued by this type of a play? And they thought that, you know, over the offseason, going into a second season, some of that would go away. Thus far, still looks a lot like his rookie year.
He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down. The quick throw by Burrow is complete. Give him a gain of five on the completion. And that will bring up third and one. If you're these receivers, you got to be ready, because when he's going to throw it quick on that RPO, he's going to throw it quick.
And this is why you spend time with your guy, either in the offseason, during the week, the whole bundle. Because sometimes it's just telepathy. You both see the same thing, and he knows, get the ball to him right away.
And he is going to have a Jags first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert there on third and one. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. On first down, right back to ETN. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. That one good for a gain of 13 for Jacksonville and a first down. Throw right side is going to be caught by Kirk. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
No coverage bust by the defense here. They did a nice job accounting for everybody, and that led to an incompletion.
The first down line at the 34 here on third down. Burrow will throw. He'll drop this one off with ETN. And he's going to come up a few yards short of the first. They get him to the ground at the 37. So now on comes the field goal unit. And wow, this is no ordinary try here. And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good. And this will remain a scoreless game.
Charles, 54 yards. I'm surprised that came up short.
I would agree with that one, because normally, if he misses, it's accuracy, not length, because he has plenty of leg for that. But maybe it's like I hit my golf shot, you know? Maybe it's like my wedge. You know, when you chili dip and you hit the ground ahead of it, sometimes that'll shorten your distance as well.
And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
Part of their struggles last week was getting these negative plays on first and second down. That's something they have to be wary of as this game continues.